The most expedient way to defeat any enemy is to find and exploit their greatest weakness. And in 2020, in America and in the world at large, the people's greatest weakness and thus their greatest vulnerability is through their mind. Once one believes that an entry point is protected and thus not needing as much attention is when the opponent chooses to attack that entry point. The people's greatest weakness right now is through information and the sources of information that we choose to trust. As we watch the mainstream media, let us all be very, very aware that these sources have been compromised. Tactic number one is distraction. Don't look here, look over there. Don't look at this, look over there. Constantly diverting your attention to some other potential vulnerability where you cannot trust it. Don't look here, look over there. Tactic number two is repetition. When you hear the same thing over and over again from a quote-unquote variety of different sources, it just makes it more and more true with each time you listen to it. Tactic number three is fear. If you're afraid, you have a high stress level, not only in your physical human body, but just in your mind. If you're stressed, you don't know, you question everything that's happening, and you're looking to this source to give you that protection. If you're afraid, you are vulnerable. Tactic number four is emotion. If I can use your human emotion to exploit you, to make you do or act differently than you already normally would, and I know that you're fearful and that you believe that this source is protected, you are completely exposed. Tactic number five is social validation or groupthink. If I can get you to think that you are outside of the norm, you are the conspiracy theorist, you are the one that is outside of the means, you are the extremist, you are not part of the team, you are not part of the tribe, you begin to retreat. Tactic number six is suppression. If I can suppress any other information or any other source or any other means that may question your belief in the primary source, me, the one you can trust, there's nothing else that can change your mind. Tactic number seven is intimidation. If I can get you to believe that if you dare question the narrative, if you dare question the source, look at how all these other people are being destroyed. Look what's happening to them. You don't want that to happen to you. Aren't you afraid? Tactic number eight is reliance. If I can get you to rely on this source, rely on someone else for protection, rely on information, rely on someone else for truth, that means that you are not seeking it or acting on it yourself. Tactic number nine is safety and the illusion of safety. Here's a newsflash. You are not safe unless you protect yourself, your body, your mind, your finances, your interests. You are the one that is responsible for protecting yourself. Safety is an illusion, and it is something that you need to handle now, tomorrow, and till forever. Tactic number 10 is the creation of false idols, elevating people that you theoretically know, like, and trust to a position of authority, authority beyond what you know inherently, instinctively within yourself. Look at what these people are doing. Look at how these celebrities are acting. Look at how these political figures, look at how these people of authority do it. That's how you're supposed to do it. Aren't you like them? Don't you want to be like them? So think about how all these tactics are being played on us right now. Think about our vulnerability. Think about how if we see something in real life, if we see someone attacking us, we know what to do. But the attack through your mind, the most vulnerable entry point, is what is being exploited right now at a rate never before seen. We trust the mainstream media. We trust the news sources. We trust the newspapers. We trust all these institutions that have been supposedly feeding us the truth for many, many years. That's where they're attacking us. What is more important now, more than ever, is that we all do our own independent research about every single piece of information, every thought, every consideration that comes across our mind. Every single thing should be questioned from me, from the next guy, from the next girl, from the next news source, from the next newspaper, from the next headline, from the next TV station. We need to turn off the mainstream news source, and we need to be independently searching, researching, and fact-checking every piece of information we see. The dare to be great situation, the heroic moment that you've always looked for, is upon us right now. Now is the time to be a patriot. Now is the time to think independently. Now is the time to open conversations with your fellow man and woman and know that we are all in this together, that an attack on your mind is an attack on all of us. And if we do not stand up independently and together simultaneously, we will be destroyed. It is our only path to freedom. Now think about how all these tactics are being used to infiltrate your mind right now, and especially the minds of people around you. If you found your way to this content, it shows that you are already on the path to more freedom. You are already independently thinking. Now you need to be responsible for spreading it, for sharing it, for telling your fellow person, for helping them understand that it is not what it seems, and that if they expect to be free and to be safe, and they think that someone else can handle that for them, they are dead wrong. There are more of us than there are of them, and it is our responsibility to save our republic, to save America, to save and preserve freedom and God-given rights. If we do not stand up, if you do not stand up with our thoughts, with our words, with our actions, we will lose the last piece, the last shred of freedom that maybe the world has ever seen. We need to save America, and socialism will destroy every single thing we've ever known. We need to protect ourselves, and now is the time. Stand up for freedom. Spread the word. Open conversations. Fight socialism. Fight reliance. Support independent, God-given rights, and support and endorse and protect freedom.